So in this video, we're gonna bring animation into our VR scene. We've remixed the last app and have starter-aframe-animated.glitch.me, where we now have the planets orbiting. Melissa's gonna show us how it works.
I've created a remix of the animated planetarium. That way we can play around with the code and see how it works. Let's open it up. So when I click and drag, I'm rotating the sun. It's a little bit different than in the previous starters. These are called orbit controls. Let's head back to index.html and look at our code. When I scroll down, I can see this line, use our new orbit controls. And you can see, this is the values for it. What happens when I remove them? It goes back to the default value. But I love the orbit controls because it allows us to see the whole solar system at once. Now, what about our animation? So the animations are right here. And these are called mixins. I use a mixin when I have something I want to do a lot of different things in my scene, but I don't want to repeat the same code over and over again. So without a mixin, I'd have to put this animation on every single one of the planets. And we have a lot of planets, and I don't want to do that. So instead, I create this mixin, I name it orbit, and then I can reference it in my code. So to orbit Mercury, I just use mixin equals orbit. Let's put our code side by side with our planetarium. That way we can see what happens when we change things. So for example, here's Mercury. What happens when I remove orbit? It's no longer orbiting. Another massive advantage to mixins is that you can change the orbits for all the planets at once. So instead of having to change a bunch of orbits to make my planetarium faster, I'll just change one. So I'm gonna change this from 40,000 to 10,000. Now I have a faster planetarium. Neat. Check out the README for more information about mixins and animation. We look forward to seeing what cool things you do with this starter.
I've used animation, some animation things. One was just like a fading. I think that this is kind of a popular one, but it's in terms of transitioning the surrounding environment. If you're like resetting the sky or the panorama of your environment, what it'll do is the screen will like slowly like fade to black, and then a new image will appear, and it has the effect of like blinking and then opening your eyes to a new scene. But I think that is kind of a nice animation. I've also used timing animations where you say, in this amount of time, I want maybe this object to move to here, and maybe the velocity is linear, maybe it like speeds up in the middle and slows down. You can also ascribe like laws of physics to certain objects.
So when you're working with the animation and light introduced in this starter, the A-frame inspector is super helpful. You can open it by pressing Ctrl+Li on Windows or Ctrl+Option+I on Mac. Let's click Show to see our planetarium so we can open it up and take a look. Ctrl+Option+I opens it up. So what about lighting? Let's explore lighting first. I'm gonna click on the sun. And I read about these cool stars called O-type stars. And they're blue stars. And I wanna see if I can turn the sun blue, just like a O-type star. So I'm gonna click light. And it has this value called color. And if I click here, I can open up this color picker. And I'm gonna select blue. And that generates a hex value, which we learned about in the first starter. So you can see the lighting here now is blue. And we can make it more intense to show it a little bit more dramatically. So intensity is this value, and right now it's 1, and I'm gonna make it 5. That's a little too bright. What about 2? Great. So I like this, and I'm gonna copy to clipboard, and then I'm gonna go into my index.html and look for my sun code. So my sun code is up here. And I'm gonna paste the code from the inspector, and I'm gonna replace this light here. light attribute. Now delete this. And when I open up my scene, I should see the blue light. Now I'm going to make my sun blue too. So right now there's no color attributed to sun, so I'm going to put in color equals blue. Awesome. What about animation? So you can do that in A-Frame Inspector too. Control-Option-I to open it. And then we have this super handy play button. So if I play, I can visualize the animation. And it's kind of hard to edit things that are moving, so I can click pause to just pause it. So I want to make Mercury slower. If you go back to the README, you can read a little bit about how to do that. So there's this attribute called duration. And smaller means faster. We can also take a look at the A-Frame Animation Component documentation. Tells us a little bit more about the details right here. And it's milliseconds to complete the animation. So if I increase them, it'll make it slower. I'm going to try it out. So I'm going to take this and make this duration. Right now it's 20,000. I'm going to increase it to 80,000. Now I'm going to click play. Sweet, we have a slow Mercury now. I'm going to copy that using this button. Let's go back to our code and find Mercury. And since I don't want to change all this stuff, I'm going to just copy the animation duration part. And I'm going to paste it in here. Okay. Well, hopefully this helps you customize your own animation and lights for your cool planetarium.
In this video, we discuss how you can use animation to bring your A-frame scene to life. You want to see how it's done? Check out starter-aframe-animated.glitch.me. You can view the source code and remix it to make your own scenes. In the next video, we're going to talk about some really cool stuff you can do with JavaScript and custom shaders. We hope you'll join us.